Well, I'm passionate about the city because I was born and raised here in Worcester, and I'm the product of Worcester Public Schools. And I'm passionate about this school because I believe that vocational technical education is the right education for so many of our youth.
You'll help. You'll be our financial planner?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
We actually built a full-service bank, Worcester Credit Union, at our school, training tellers.
Oh, so what are we doing?
I'm getting manicures.
Manicures? We have a cosmetology department.
This is the veterinary tech program, and our kids are working with Tufts University. This is Auto Collision, and people from our community bring their vehicles in for service.
We have a 16-bay auto garage that services over 250 vehicles a month. At Worcester Technical High School, we have 24 different technical programs. And what we want to do, the goal was to align business and industry and develop business partners.
Do you guys know about the Business Expo?
She brought here a different philosophy. She focused on data, MCAS scores, academics, all right, focusing on excellence, high standards. She brought a feeling of positiveness. Everyone can achieve. We're great. You can do it. Encouragement, and to the community, she reaches out. She has the school reach out. She has the teachers reach out. The students reach out.
I started teaching there in 1976 at what used to be called Girls Trade. We had Girls Trade and Boys Trade School. Kids went there for trades, and academic teachers didn't really have a role outside of making sure that the kids get enough credits so that they qualified for a diploma.
Don't leave me hanging. Don't leave me hanging. All right. Awesome. Nice job, guys.
Sheila has been an inspiration to the school and to the community. She brought her vision to the new facility. And, you know, part of that was being able to gather the teachers, gather both the technical and academic teachers. It's kind of like two different worlds, and bring them together.
There is a culture of collaboration, not only at her level, but it drops down into the department level, so we're collaborating all the time. And I think it's her leadership style that has allowed us to feel that we can share with one another. And what we have here is a group of people who come together to work together for one solid goal, and that is the success of our students. One of the biggest reasons why the school is successful is because of the collaboration with the teachers that teach academics and with the vocational teachers.
So everyone gets an opportunity to share in the education of the students here.
So exactly what were you working on?
I walk the school all the time. I go into academic and technical, but what I love to see is when the light bulb is going off, and you can see that when they're, especially in some of the trades or all the trades, when they're working with their hands, working on a project or completing something that they're so proud of. It's written all over their face.
I like it. That's pretty cool.
She sets the bar high for herself, sets the bar high for her staff, and then gives you the resources to reach that. And that's, I think, part of her success is giving us the means to reach where we want to be also. And I think it raises the level for everybody. We all just know that what the expectation is, and are given the resources to achieve it.
She is a true leader in that she allows me to make decisions and gives me that autonomy to make decisions. At the same time, you know, I'm held accountable for those decisions. It makes you feel empowered. It makes you feel like you can actually do something wonderful at the school, and that you're valued, and that your department's valued as well.
That's even better. That's cool. Good for you.
There's 150 staff members here at Worcester Tech, and everybody has very strong skill sets in certain areas. And it's really important to empower people so they can reach their full potential. And so many people just needed the green light to do their best and to showcase their skills and to put them in the right light to succeed. Because when our staff succeeds, our students succeed.
Everything to her is about Worcester Technical High School. She loves the school. And you can see it in how she manages our school.
I don't think any one principal can do it alone. My advice to any principal, especially principals that are starting off, Don't expect to know everything, because you don't and you can't. And pull in people and recruit people that can help you, and bring in masters of their trade, so to speak. Hire the best English and math, science and social studies people that you can, and empower them to take risks and that are calculated, and also to really bring education and learning alive for the students, and then build on the momentum.